You have 24 hours notice. SHGF is happening in 24 hours. What do you do? Hey everybody, this is Michael with Asymmetrical Preparedness. Seriously, 24 hour notice for SHGF, for a big event. What do you do? How do you prepare? What do you need to do? What do you need to grab? Those kind of things. First, the biggest thing is knowing what you have. Knowing what your weaknesses are. What do you need? What gaps can you fill in short term? Also, what is the situation? Is it a bug in situation or is it a bug out situation? Big difference in what you do. First thing is, one of the most important things is keep cash on hand, emergency fund. Because if you do so, no matter what happens, you might have the ability to grab some extra supplies before you bug in or before you head out, before you get out of Dodge. Those kind of things are very important. So have some cash on hand. Assess what you have. And after assessing what you have, think about what you need. Think about what you might need. This is continual basis also. This is every day. You should be doing on a regular basis. This may not every day, but you guys know what I mean. Make a list now, not in the 24-hour period. Make a list now for your 24-hour list. This is what I need to grab. This is what I need to have with me. Have a copy on your fridge. Have a copy in your primary vehicle. And sorry about the noises. That's the little one riding her bike. which I'm not going to apologize for, actually, because kids are a blessing and family is awesome. Big family man here, so hey, I guess you're just going to have to deal with the noise in the background, because my little girl is awesome. Make a list. So then if you're bugging in and need to go to the grocery store, grab a couple last minute things, you can grab it off the fridge. If you're on the way home, just one sec. If you're on the way home, have it in your vehicle. Grab a couple things. Have different lists though, if you're bugging out or bugging in. Bugging out, have a list like in your bug out bags. When you grab it, throw it in the vehicle, you can grab the list and you can get stuff en route to your bug out location if you can. You may not be able to, but if you can, it's a good opportunity to get last minute things. What do you need? What can you get easily? What do you think is gonna be available? Those kind of things you need to think about. And your bug in, bug out plans. What do you need for that? What's incorporated as part of that? What to do list. Like I said, bug in, bug out, big difference in what you get, what you need, and how you're gonna go about doing it. If I know SHGF is happening tomorrow. Well, on my way home from work, maybe it's happening tomorrow night. On my way home from work tomorrow, well, if I knew it was happening tomorrow night, I wouldn't go to work. But say, 24-hour notice when you get off of work. So on your way home, grab things. I pretty much know up here what I'm gonna grab. And it's different for all of us. Maybe water for you, maybe bulk foods for you, maybe canned goods for you, maybe medical, whatever your weak areas are, try to just up them a little bit. Don't count on this though. This is just one thing that you might be able to do. Bug in, yeah, grab some extras on your way home, then settle in, set security, do your thing. If you're bugging out, pack, hit the road, grab what you can en route. Grab your stashes, your caches, stuff like that. But be thinking about what is applicable to you in a scenario like this. You have 24-hour notice of something is gonna go down. Like I said, it's different for everybody. You may need some extra firewood. You may need, I don't know. I don't know what you need. You know what you need. That's part of your self-assessment, your continual self-assessment. Seeing, analyzing your preps, looking through your stuff, knowing what you have, knowing what you need, all those kind of things. And if you're well-rounded, just use this as an opportunity to top off a couple things or get a couple morale items. Maybe grab some candy bars, maybe grab some cake mixes, maybe grab some sugar, maybe grab some candy, maybe grab some mac and cheese, whatever it is for you. Or maybe some extra fuel. I don't know. Like I said, I can't answer you. All I can do is empower you guys to use this. Using this, this is your most powerful tool as a prepper. It's not these, it's this. Your head is the most important thing. Your knowledge, your abilities to be flexible, to get through and to solve problems. Those are the big things. So this is an exercise. Sit down tonight, today, whenever you're watching this video, after the video is over, and with your family, your friends, whoever is involved in your life, and make a 24-hour list. What do we need to grab in 24 hours? Make two lists and then copy them. Like I said, so you have a couple copies here and there. Maybe carry one in your wallet, if you carry a wallet. I don't know. Whatever it is. What your needs are, what things you need to round out, what things you need to top off, what weaknesses you need to fill, anything of the sort. And talk amongst your friends. Maybe communications is important. So maybe on the way home, you can grab by a sporting goods store and grab some FRS radios. I don't know. So, but you know, and you can figure it out. Even if you don't know, you got to use this. So I'm encouraging you guys to use this and to get with whoever your group is, your family, your friends, your neighbors, whoever it might be. Come up with a plan. Also along these lines, come up with a security plan. What are you going to do if it's a situation where you need to be secure? Maybe it's a big threat of bad guys or something. I don't know. Only you know that. So analyze what you need, what your threats are in your area, and plan accordingly. This is part of your prepping a little every day. Prepping a little every day. It's very important. Your fitness is important also. That's not something you do in 24 hours, though. So keep working on that now. This is the time where it's easy. Things are getting more expensive. I get it. Things are getting tougher. I get it. But things are still good, fairly good. Some people are suffering. A lot of people are still suffering. I get it, and I really feel for those people right here. I pray for everybody all the time. So also get right with him if that's important to you. It's important to me. I know. So anyway, I love you guys. Please think about this. Take this for action and be ready to go if you're in a situation where you have 12 hours, 24 hours, 36 hours, whatever notice. And it may be, 24-hour notices before the storm is going to hit or something like that. It may be that kind of thing where you need to get out of Dodge. You need to go to a bug-out location. You need to go to a friend's house. You need to go to high ground, whatever it may be. You need to get out of the state because of a volcano. Who knows? We don't know what's going to go on. We just know that we need to plan for all these eventualities and help mitigate or try to work on mitigating the risks so that we can thrive, not just survive. Remember, prepping is living insurance. I love you guys, and thank you so much for being here. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, make some comments, and you guys are awesome. Have a blessed day, and blessings to you and yours.